And we're back here one final time as the fireworks are starting to go off here at Tom Adams Field. And the fireworks tonight, you can see the fireworks in the background, but most of the fireworks were supplied by the Ferris State offense, especially in that first half, as they scored 35 points in the opening half and won this one going away 59-13. Back with Rod Beard, I'm Kevin Breckmacher, and really all you can say in the outset of how we analyze this game is Ferris State punched Wayne State in the mouth early on. Wayne State didn't get off the mat, and it was just a bulldog kind of steam effect from that point.
Yeah, and when you face the number two team in the country, that's what you're going to expect, is that you have to play mistake-free football and get some stops. Wayne State didn't get those stops. They didn't make them punt one time in this game, and that's the result of it, is you're going to see a dominant team with the best player in the country assert that dominance, and they did that on both sides of the ball today too.
Let's take a look at the highlights, and we saw some of them at halftime, and we'll take a look at some of the first half highlights again. And it was just big play after big play after big play for Ferris State.
Yeah, this throw was just so impressive from Jeru Campbell. Back foot, fading back, but still able to get that downfield. Sets up the first touchdown run, which he takes himself. Gets in. It's a 7-0 lead for the Bulldogs in that first quarter. Here's another escapability play for him. Gets a first down and sets up another big score for him.
Yeah, that was on a third and about 14. That was one of the big plays in that first quarter that switched momentum. So it was still 7-0 at that point.
Yeah, Campbell there directing traffic, puts it up there for Cy Barnett for a 46-yard touchdown pass.
And here's Campbell again with his elusiveness. That was another third down conversion that he picked up the first down and got the extra 15 yards as well. And again, he was on the money on those deep throws all night long.
Yeah, Cy Barnett there again, 36 yards. Barnett had 5 catches, 139 yards, 2 scores in the game, and really call it a half of football.
There's Deion Earls. You mentioned him a lot tonight, off that swing pass, and he played a big role in this game as well. And Campbell with another touchdown scamper. This time it wasn't even touched, and it's like the Red Sea parted for him going into the end zone that time.
Right, you just got to pick your poison with him, is that if you're going to blitz him, he's going to beat you in the air. If you try to sit back, he's going to pick you apart too.
This is Harrington. And the weapons that Ferris State just kept throwing at you, Harrington, all the guys off the bench, and there's one of them right there.
That's a pro-level pass. I mean, just the awareness and the footwork there for Campbell.
And then we go to the second half. Not much better for Wayne State's defense as Ferris State took the opening kickoff and went down and scored another touchdown.
Yeah, that made it 42-0 on that minor run there, and Wayne State finally starts to get something going themselves.
Eggleston with that scoop, and I thought he might score in a minute, but like we said, he kind of ran out of gas in the tank and got down to about the 30-yard line.
Yeah, and that sets it up, and just Wayne State needed something to get going. You see Jake Amrine, who came in the late in the second half, and then you get that throw to Potterack for the touchdown.
That was the first touchdown of the game for Wayne State. Missed the extra point, and then that was Burrell going up the middle of that spin move at the end for another touchdown for the Bulldogs.
That's 49-6 for you. And then going into the fourth quarter, slowed down a bit. Wayne State gets this fumble recovery or the muff punt recovery, and that sets up in Amrine, a Stephen Glenn touchdown, 21 yards. Extra points good, 52-13.
Nice to see both tight ends get in the end zone tonight.
Yeah, you want to see Roberson in there somewhere too in that passing game. We mentioned that the receivers were so diminished, depleted by injury.
And that was a touchdown after that controversial fake punt at the end of the game to make it 59-13. And again, the rushing totals 337 to -3 tell the story right there.
Yeah, and Wayne State just never got going. Offensively, the Ferris State defensive line was so stout, so good, and making sure that Wayne State didn't get those big plays, especially on first down. You see the disparity in first downs, 31-8. Wayne State just never offensively got into this game.
And again, the only thing you could really pick on for Ferris State, 12 penalties for 110 yards, and they did turn it over 4 times. And we talked a lot in the second half about if they're going to make another big tournament run to get to the national championship game again. You can't commit 12 penalties against really good teams. You can't turn it over 4 times. But tonight it didn't matter. They were just too good for Wayne State.
Yeah, and again, it's the number two team in the country. They're going to do this to a lot of teams. Wayne State has to kind of get things cleaned up ahead of next week's game against Ashland. Going to be another tough test for them.
It doesn't get any easier against Ashland, who won again today, and they're going to be tied with Wayne State for second place in the GLIAC. So another big game next week. Ferris State now 24 straight regular season wins. They're halfway home to another perfectly yak slate here in 2019. So that'll do it tonight from Tom Adams Field. Thanks a lot to our great, hardworking crew. A great job, as always, best in the business. For Tony Ortiz, braving the weather downstairs, and Rod Beard, I'm Kevin Breckmacher saying so long. You've been watching Wayne State football on CN900. Come back next week. We'll be back here 6 p.m. as the Ashland Eagles take on the Wayne State Warriors. Again, final score one final time tonight. Ferris State 59, Wayne State 13. Have a great weekend, everybody.